haunt me, even when you're not around.
Hi, my name is Deidre Woodward, and I'm from Washington State.
I'm Shelby Van Hellen. I'm from Tasmania, Australia.
And this is our field.
Yeah.
In the fall, we practice 4 times a week and have games every Friday and Sunday.
And in the spring, we train 3 times a week and we get around 5 competition games.
This is our bench where we sit for games. Some fun facts about our field is that it's Bermuda grass, which is only found in the south.
Some also fun facts is we play under lights on a Friday night, which is really different from other teams in this week. This is our bench where we sit through practice. It's also the opponent's bench through games.
We don't have a men's team or any other sports that use this field, so it's just ours and we get to use it whenever we want.
Boundaries, I will try to knock them down. I'm latching on, babe. Now I know what I have found.
Is the Annex weight room facility.
So basically during season we're in the weight room twice a week, and then during spring season we're in it 3 times a week for about 1 hour to 1 hour 15, and then we kick it over to Marley for some conditioning on the field.
Here in the weight room facilities, our trainers are really great. They range from legs to arms, and then we always finish off every session with some core.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
It's very beneficial for our soccer players because they make it very sport-specific with the workouts, so we're not stuck doing football or volleyball training each day. They make it new, fresh, so that it's more exciting and really gets us jazzed up for season.
Texas, and this is a recruiting lounge. This is where we have our preseason meetings, and this is where all the recruits come to talk and socialize.
And this is also where we watch film.
This is a brand new football stadium where we host all the home football games, and it was open on Thanksgiving Day 2012.
This is where the Mighty Marching Hornet Band and the Stingheads and the Honeybees perform every halftime on home games.
Hey guys, welcome to the soccer locker room. This is our domain.
And we're one of the few female athlete teams to have their very own locker room.
So come on in. This is where we come before every game, in between practices, during preseason, and store all of our stuff. We got pictures, some cleats, and own personal locker tags.
Hopefully everyone gets their own locker, but sometimes we have to double up, which, you know, isn't a bad thing. It means we have plenty of players ready to come out and commit to this team.
We get a bunch of equipment. We have 4 different uniforms. We get our own practice gear, new cleats, new running shoes every year. It's some great stuff.
A lot of team bonding happens during our preseason, so we spend most of our time in here.
Where we do scouting report. Molly comes in and talks to us a little bit about the team before we go out and take the field, and then normally gives us some good advice or quote to get us pumped.
California.
Hi, I'm Emily Zilkowski and I'm from Nevada.
This is what we call our football complex. This is where football holds all of their practices. It
even sometimes we'll come out here and we'll do our workouts. And there's even a weight room right there, and we'll do some of our weight room workouts in there.
I'm so encaptured, got me wrapped up in your touch.
This is the second weight room facility on campus for athletes.
So enamored, hold me tight within your clutch.
Inside the football complex, we have an athlete computer lab, which makes it easier for you to do your work and print off your papers for free.
They also have like a Mac lab and a Dell lab, so whatever computer you want to use.
I saw all the Buzz iCafe that probably serves Starbucks and other snacks, healthy snacks. It's just another section you could do your homework and watch the news.
And you can eat here, so you can buy something and eat in here, study, work with a friend, do whatever you want to do.
Okay, so this is the fifth floor of the library, like I said, where we usually spend most of our time. As you can see, here are all the lovely books.
Just open it. Head exercises. Are you coming?
Yeah.
This
is one of the big areas where most athletes have their study hall sessions. Nice and spacious. And
this is the Dell Lab where mostly people come.
You can literally do anything on these computers. You mainly come here because you can print a lot of papers, so you can come here and print and do your work.
Okay, so also one of the many cool things about this library is it has extra textbooks, and so if you're waiting to get yours or if you just don't have money to buy one, you can check them out, but you have to come early because they obviously go quickly.
And this is the athletic training room.
Hello, my name is Mariel Smith, and
this is where athletes go to get treatment. For example, here is Joshua getting game ready, and this is the STEM machine for STEM.
And some more fun facts about the training room is we actually have not one, but two ice baths, which we definitely use during preseason.
This is where I get my ankle taped.
This is another training room facility, and over here is our other teammate, Allie, doing workouts before practice because she's injured.
This is where we do rehab.
She's just in.
Oh, yeah. There you go. That's the way to do it. Good job, teammate.
The first room of training room. Do not come in here loud.
Hey, guys.
Hey, shh. Quiet.
The second room of training room. Do not have your headphones in. The third rule of training room, do not, I repeat, do not fall asleep.
Could I lock in your love, baby?
Oh, and this is where we get all of our textbooks, university campus apparel and stuff.
And all scholarship athletes get free textbooks.
And if you need like candy or snacks or water bottles, they're in there.
They're in there. This is the food court.
Where you get subway, perch rolls, different wings, burgers, stuff that you don't want to eat at the gas.
Also, it's a lot of social area. People spend half their time here when they don't have classes. A campus game room.
There's like ping pong, pool,
cards, and then there's multiple TVs.
And that plays very important sports games.
Like, big sports games.
That everyone comes to watch together.
And then this is the Academic Advisor Center where we get our schedules made each semester.
Yeah, this is where you need to like make your schedules, if you need to drop classes, if you need to change classes, if you need help with classes, you go.
Our academic advisor is Tremaine Moore, or AKA Scoop. This is a movie on the lawn. It's an amphitheater, and there's like a huge screen that comes down from over here, and they play movies often.
Is the cashier office? Yes, this is where if you need money or like quarters to do laundry, you can come and exchange it here.
And if you have work study or if you get a refund check, your checks will come through here.
This is the theater.
There's movies often.
And then sometimes we have our dolls meetings in here.
Our doll meetings contain of all the female athletes on campus. Come here, we talk about life.
Girl stuff.
Girl talk.
Basketball train, and volleyball also has their games here. And throughout the week, they offer free yoga and Zumba classes to students.
Also located in Lockhart is Coach's office. This is where we hold all of our meetings.
In this building, it's like suite living, so you have a roommate, and then you guys share a bathroom with two suite mates. So So either the laundry is located on each floor or it's all the way in the basement. So this is the acrobat. This
is the home of our basketball team, homecoming concerts, conferences, tournaments, anything grand you can name it, it happens right here. And believe it or not, it wasn't open until 1992. I want you to guess how many seats are even in this Acadome. Things that happen in this Acadome, I can tell you there's compliance, there's student activities that take over our media pages, for example, ASU Buzz, which you can follow on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. This is how we do it. This is how we do it.
Softball complex where the women's softball team practices and plays their games.
This is how we do it. It's Friday night.
This is Wheeler Watkins Baseball Complex.
Shelby, did you know?
Know what?
That Coach Wheeler was one of the first ASU baseball coaches, and Coach Watkins is the most winningest coach of ASU baseball history.
The party's here on the west side, so I reach for my 40 and I turn it up. Designated driver, take the keys to my truck. Hit the shot cause I'm faded. Honey's in the street.
Hi, I'm Elena Smith. I'm a junior here. I'm from Conyers, Georgia.
And I'm Kayla, and I'm from Auburn, Alabama. I'm a freshman.
Part of this video is going to show you a little bit about the landmarks on campus, and behind me are the two houses. On your left is Ralph David Abernathy, and on the right is Natalie Cole. Okay, on our next stop, we're here at the Homebody Hall. This is one of two. This is our music building, home to our Mighty Marching Hornets band, one of the top HBCU bands in the nation.
Money, oh, we made it. It feels so good. My hood tonight. The summertime skirts and my guys in Kanai. All my gangbangers forgot about the drive-by. You gotta get your groove.
Our next landmark is dedicated to the one and only Rosa Parks. Rosa Parks is one of the most influential players in the civil rights movement because she refused to give up her seat. This is our monument here on Alabama State to dedicate to her how much she means to us and how much she paved the way for us as students.
This is the ASU Tennis Center. Come follow us inside to see what's up.
Let's flip the track from the old school bag. This is how we do it. This is how we do it. All hands are in the air. And wave them from here to there. If you're an OG Mac or a wannabe player, you see the hood's been good to me ever since I was a lowercase G. But now I'm a big G. The girls see I got the money, $100 bills, y'all. If you were from where I'm from, then you would know that I gotta get mine in a big black truck. You can get yours in a six-ball.
Thanks for coming to campus. Hope to see you soon.